Hi everyone, this is John Dickinson from motionworks.net, back with another Sapphire tip for you. This time we're going to take a look at Sapphire's Aurora effect. And with Sapphire Aurora, you can create Aurora Borealis style looks and other lighting effects. But these are only part of what Sapphire Aurora can be used for. Under the hood, it's a powerful generator effect. And when combined with other effects using Sapphire's Effect Builder, you can create a variety of really interesting looks like these. And using Aurora in this way is definitely my favorite approach. So let's take a quick look at how you can set up Aurora as a generator effect inside of Sapphire Effect Builder. And the first thing I'm going to do with this Aurora layer selected is apply S-Effect. I'm going to click on Load Preset and just type in Aurora. And I'm going to choose this one here, Swirling Mesh. And then come back up to the top of the effect and click on Edit Effect to open up the Effect Builder. Click on the Aurora node, and notice with this effect that softness is set to zero. This is giving quite a sharp look. If I increase that, we start to move back towards that more Aurora Borealis style lighting look. So let's just adjust this slightly. I'm going to drop Swirl Complexity to 1, and Swirl Magnitude to about 0.4. And I'm going to come down to the lighting settings, and I'm going to increase the light radius to about 5. And that removes that soft vignette from the edges of the effect. Okay, now next I want to apply Sapphire Blur Motion. So I'm going to type that in over here in the left-hand column. Blur, Blur Motion. And because I had the Aurora node selected, it dropped that effect directly below by double-clicking. Okay, so for brightness, I'm going to increase that to 2.5. And I'm going to drop the to Z distance right down. Maybe about 0.3, that looks pretty good. Next, I'm going to add the mosaic effect. Just double click to apply that. I'm going to increase the pixel frequency to 60. And I'm going to change pixel rel height to 10. Just like that. And I want to mix this with the layers below. So I'm going to set mix with source to 0.7. So now we can see the bars and we can see these nice soft light rays. Okay, so next I'm going to apply Collider Polar. Just like that. And we're getting pretty close to the look I was after. Might make it a little bit brighter. So I'll use Gamma for that. And just increase the scale lights. Just bring that up to brighten this up. I'll often use the gamma effect in the bottom of the stack just to make some adjustments. And lastly, before we go back to After Effects, I just want to solo some of these parameters. So for Collider Polar, I just want to turn off all of the parameters. And I want to just solo center. And for Aurora, I just want to solo the seed. Uncheck Preview Selected Node and click OK. So you can see quickly and easily inside of Effect Builder, by having Aurora as a generator effect and then adding a range of different effects, we can come up with a really beautiful look. And here's my Aurora seed. I can just drag that value and just audition different looks. And here's my Collider Polar center position. So I can just move that around and just see if it looks better on the side or in the corner. So I have total flexibility to move it wherever I want. And of course, once you've created the look that you like, you can save that as a preset just by clicking on the Save Preset button and typing in the relevant information. Effects like Sapphire Aurora and Sapphire Caustics are really useful generators inside of Sapphire Builder. And as you can see, it only took me a few moments to come up with a really unique look. Thanks for watching, and be sure to click on the link in the description to download a free trial of Sapphire for After Effects and check out these great plugins for yourself. Also follow Boris Effects on YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter to stay up to date with the latest information and training materials on Continuum, Sapphire, Mocha Pro, and all of the Boris Effects products.